فليقولوا عن حجابي
لا وربي لن أبالي
فليقولوا عن حجابي أنه يفني شبابي وليغالوا في عتابي إن للدين انتسابي.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن اتبع بهديه واقتدى بسنته إلى يوم الدين وبعد. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. إن شاء الله تعالى today we will go over سورة الإخلاص. قل هو الله أحد اس کا نام ہے سورة إخلاص. إخلاص means purity, sincerity. إخلاص in our language we say إخلاص also جس کے پاس صحیح نیت ہو. So those kind of tarjuma and translation can be taken from the word ikhlas. The overview of this surah is very beautiful. I'll explain a few incidents also inshallah ta'ala. So happened that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he used to give da'wah to worship on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then the mushrikeens of Makkah, unhone kabhi mauka nahi chora, they never left any stone unturned in doing the insult of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So as we know that wukhud, they used to worship boot idols, and they will have over 360 idols that they used to worship, man-made gods and man-made khuda they used to worship. So they used to say to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam ke yaar tum kiski ibadat karte ho, humko to kuch nazar nahi aata. Who do you worship? We don't see anyone you worship. Aap jisse ibadat karte ho, the person you worship, hamare paas to itne zyada boot hai, so many idols, we worship this idol, we worship this idol, we worship this idol, we take food to them. This idol is the biggest one. Then this is the children's one. This is the one for the rain. This is the one for summer, for winter. Tumhara khuda to nazar hi nahi aata. You know, they used to mock Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and insult him like this. So they used to ask, "Acha, agar tumhara khuda hai, if you have a prophet, a nabi, then if you have Allah, then." That Allah, that Khuda will have a nasab nama, a family, a generation. So, can you please tell us the generation, the family tree of your Khuda, of your Allah, of your God? We have our idols, Hamara Boot, and each idol have got their own family tree. This is the oldest one, this is also. So they used to insult Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam like this. کہ تمہارا خدا کا نسب نامہ بیان کرو. Family tree. What's the family tree of your خدا, of your Lord? So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because we are muwahid, we worship one Allah. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam always is to wait for Allah to send revelation in terms of any question that they will have, any sawal they will have. So when this insult came a lot from the mushrikeen, Allah Rabbul Izzat revealed Surah Al-Ikhlas and Qul Huwa Allahu Ahad. Allah revealed this surah to challenge them that you asking the question about Nasab Nama of Allah. So Allah is saying Qul Huwa Allahu Ahad. Allah is one. There is no Nasab Nama, there is no family tree to Allah. So obviously then the surah goes further on. That's one of the Mufassirun have mentioned one point. The second point I have mentioned is that actually the Yahud now, not the Mushrikeen, the Yahud, they will bring the incident of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. Okay, jab Musa alayhi salatu wasalam went Allah ko milne ke liye pahar ke upar, to Samiri, the person who was left behind, usne ek bachra banaya tha, and he gave life to this animal, and the whole Banu Israel started worshipping this animal made of gold or whatever it was made of. So the Yahud will come to insult Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is another narration that at the time of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, this person Samiri, he created an animal, and this animal gave us a lot of benefit, and he was made of gold or silver, whatever, or jewelry. So we worship, our people of Banu Israel worshipped him for Khuda as a god. So tumhara khuda bhi kuch sone chani se banaya hua hai. Hamara khuda, na'udhu billah, Samiri ne jo banaya tha, the animal, he was made of gold or silver, whatever material. So what about your Allah, your khuda? Is he made of any gold or silver? So Allah Rabbul Izzat again to challenge the Yahud, he revealed this ayah or this surah, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ اللَّهُ الصَّمَدْ لَمْ يَلِدْ وَلَمْ يُولَدْ وَلَمْ يَكُلْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدْ, in which mentioned that Allah is not being created by anything. Allah is وَرَاءُ الْوَرَاء. We cannot imagine how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is. So that's why this surah was revealed. And this surah obviously emphasizes, and the main topic, main subject uske andar is that Allah ek hai, wahdaniyat, wahdaniyat hai, and tawheed. That's why jab humne suratul kafirun ki jo aap hazrat ke samne tafsir ki thi, we may explain to you suratul kafirun, we mentioned that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam's adat, sunnat, tariqa ye tha ki hamesha, aksar, most of the time, فجر کی دو سنتوں کے اندر اور مغرب کے دو سنتوں کے اندر سورة الكافرون اور سورة الاخلاص پڑھا کرتے تھے اکثر. This was his blessed sunnah. And اس کے پیچھے بھی ایک حکمت ہے, there is a wisdom behind it, that سورة الكافرون is taking shirk away from us and سورة الاخلاص is bringing oneness of Allah inside us. That was the حکمت of Rasulullah صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم. Many fazail of this surah, one of the fazail we hear many times is that many of the virtues, that this surah, if somebody recites this surah three times or once, is as uska sawab mita hai ki agar kisi ne ek martaba is surah ko pahn liya to Quran ka ek tihai Quran ki usne tilawat kar li. So this person has recited one third of the Quran if one person recites suratul ikhlas. So if somebody recites it three times, is the sawab and the reward as the person recited the whole Quran. Aur uski ek wajah hai, there's a reason to it, that the topics in the Quran, jo mazmoon Quran ke andar hai, the topics in the Quran are divided into three topics, three different mazmoon. Number one aqeedah ki hamara aqeedah sahi hona chahiye. Number 2 ibadat, roza, namaz, hajj, zakat, all these are mentioned in the Quran. And lastly, mu'amalat, transaction, apas mein len den, dealing with someone. Those three topics are mentioned in the Quran. Those three main topics are mentioned in the Quran. So if somebody will read one Suratul Ikhlas, then he will get the reward of one third of reciting the Quran, because Suratul Ikhlas is full of Tawheed. Pura Tawheed hai. So goya ke un tino sections mein se ek section us aadmi ne ya is insaan ne to pura kar liya Suratul Ikhlas padke. So that person has fulfilled it, number one. Sheikh Ahmad Lahori rahmatullah alayhi, very famous, somebody asked him, kisi ne sawal kiya ke aap rail gaadi ke upar sawar ho rahe hain aur rail gaadi chalne ke liye taiyar hai aur bas sawar ho rahe hain, aur you need to get into the rail gaadi, into the train, you need to do sawar as soon as possible, warna rail gaadi chut jayegi. With that us waqfa jo hai, jo few seconds hai aapke paas, aap us second ke dauran, in that time, can you give me the whole khulasa of the Quran? Pura Quran ka khulasa bayan kar sakte. To Sheikh Ahmad Lahori rahmatullah alayhi ne ajib jawab diya. Bahut ajib. Quran ka khulasa teen alfazon ke andar. Allah ki itaat karo ibadat karne se ke saath. Allah ki itaat karo ibadat karne ke saath. Nabi ki itaat karo sunnat ke upar pairvi karne ke saath. اور قوم کی دیکھ بھالی کرو ان کی خدمت کرنے پر. simple three mazmoon of the Quran. Simple three main topics of the Quran. He said, worship, obey Allah by worshiping Him. Obey Allah by worshiping Him. Obey Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by bringing His sunnah in your life. And lastly, do the khidmat of the community and the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. These are the three main topics that he mentioned that are in the Quran as a khulasa. As a khulasa. Now, I want to share with you, brothers, few incidents of Surah Ikhlas and how beautiful Surah Ikhlas is. I'll mention the book of Hadith, uske fazail bahut sare hai. So we just mentioned one of the fazail that obviously ke is one of the third of the Quran. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ka ma'amul tha. Amma Aisha radiallahu ta'ala farmati hai, she says that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam won't go to sleep. He won't go to sleep until he does not recite Suratul Ikhlas, Suratul Falaq, and Suratul Nas. He will never go to sleep until he doesn't recite Suratul Ikhlas, Suratul Falaq, and Suratul Nas. Once he has completed them reciting it, he will blow on his hand, dam kartete, and then he will pass it all through his body. It was his blessed sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Another fazail, another virtue mentioned in the books of hadith and tafsir that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has mentioned ke jo aadmi, anyone, jo shakhs, subah ko suratul ikhlas, suratul falaq, suratul nas. Whoever recites suratul ikhlas, suratul falaq, suratul nas in the morning and in the evening three times, Allah will protect that individual from all the calamities and all the black magic also. Yeah? All the black magics and all the calamities. And I'm going back to my point again, which I've been mentioning many times in Ramadan, that the Quran is whole ta'weez. Pura ta'weez hai Quran. Quran pura ta'weez hai. If we have Quran in our life, then there is no need to put ta'weez in our neck. There is no need to carry a ta'weez in our pockets. Because if Quran is being implemented in our daily life, and if we read the Quran, and we read the surahs that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ne farmaya, then Quran becomes our ta'weez. Allah becomes our protector. So that we don't have to rely into any ta'weez, or into any peer or anything like that. So it's very important. So this is few things that, alhamdulillah, ilm hai lakin amal nahi hai. Ilm hai lakin amal nahi hai. How long will it take us to read Suratul Ikhlas, Suratul Falaq, Suratul Nas? How long? Maximum 2-3 minutes. 2-3 minutes. Chalte firte bhi padh lo, tab bhi dam kar lo apne upar, to bhi protection ho jayega. Yeah. So just these few things are very important to read. Suratul Ikhlas was very beloved. Very beloved to the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala ajma'in. Sahaba Suratul Ikhlas se bahut pyar karte the. Bahut pyar karte the. Ek waqia likha hai ke ek sahabi the, there was a sahabi called Muawiya ibn Muawiya al-Laythi. Ek riwayat ke aitbaar se Muawiya ibn bi Muawiya al-Laythi. Ek riwayat. The other riwayat said no, his name was Muawiya ibn Abi Muawiya al-Muzni. Dono riwayat hai, dono naam likhe gaye hain. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went to Tabuk, expedition of Tabuk, jo Tabuk ka jo safar hua. If you've been to Makkah or Medina, or if Allah has taken you to the Hijaz and to Saudi Arabia, you will come to know, if you know, Tabuk from Madinatul Munawwara is approximately over 500 kilometers. Approximately over 500 kilometers. And that took place in Ramadan. The expedition of Tabuk took place in Ramadan. In deep heat. In deep heat at that time. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went with the Sahaba radiallahu anhu ajma'in. Khair, the whole thing I don't want to mention that, but I just want to mention a few points over here. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went to Tabuk. Jisko ijazat mili thi, wo thehr gaye the Madina ke andar. As we know, three Sahabas couldn't go. And putting Surah Tawbah ke andar pura wo waqiya bayan kiya gaya hai. وَعَلَى الثَّلَاثَةِ الَّذِينَ خُلِّفُوا حَتَّى إِذَا ضَاقَتْ عَلَيْهِمُ الْأَرْضُ بِمَا رَحْبَتْ وَضَاقَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ أَنفُسُهُمْ. The three Sahabas couldn't go. They had no excuse. They just didn't go. And then Allah Rabbul Izzah sent the wahi to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And then obviously they made tawbah and Allah accepted their tawbah. But some of the sahaba couldn't go because of reasons. Somebody was paralyzed, somebody was disabled, somebody was quite old age, somebody had to look after the family because there was no mahram. So Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave special arrangement and special permission to those individuals ki agar nahi aa sakte to don't worry, you stay here in Madinatul Munawwara. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam ne ijazat di thi, gave permission. Amongst them was Muawiyah ibn Abi Muawiyah al-Laythi or al-Muzni. Amongst those people was one Muawiyah ibn Muawiyah. When Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam got to Tabuk and he reached Tabuk, pahunche Tabuk ko, to obviously jo manzar hua, jo pesh hua, wo hona tha. Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam ke paas aaye. And he said to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Ya Rasulullah, a sahabi of yours has passed away in Medina. A sahabi of yours has passed away in Medina. So Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam ne arz kiya aur farmaya ke who was this sahabi? So he's mentioned Muawiyah ibn Muawiyah al-Laythi al-Muzni. Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam said that I've been commanded by Allah to notify you, to tell you that you should gather all your sahabas and perform the salatul janazah of Muawiyah ibn Muawiyah al-Laythi. How is this possible? I'm in Tabuk, he's in Medina. How is this possible? 500 kilometers, when am I going to reach? Okay, no problem. So Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam said, aap apna kaam karo, you just get the sahabas ready behind you and start the salatul janazah, get preparation for it. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasalam made preparation for it. Allah Rabbul Izzat, it was a miracle, the mu'jizat. Allah Rabbul Izzat gave Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam the qudrat and the power that Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam hit the ground. And he hit the ground, pura Madinatul Munawwara ka manzar samne aa gaya. Pura Madinatul Munawwara ka manzar samne aa gaya Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So all the hijabas, everything, as Madina Munawwara was close by. This was a mu'jiza, miracle. As this happened, the body of Muawiyah ibn Muawiyah al-Muzni al-Laythi was in front of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Nevertheless, janazah ka namaz ho gayi aur the funeral namaz was performed. Back to reality, Jibreel alayhi salatu wasallam again hit the ground and back to normality. Acha ta'ajjub huwa Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam ko, and amazed that Jibreel, maine bahut sare safar kiye, I did many journeys with my sahabas, and during those journeys many of all the sahabas have died in Makkah or Madinatul Munawwara, lekin Allah ne kabhi bhi ye hukm nahi diya tha ke is tarah ke janaza ki namaz padhao kisi sahabi ka. Ha, gaibana janaza namaz hua tha for some of the people. One of them was Muawiyah ibn Abi Muawiyah al-Muzani wal-Laythi, and one of them was the king of Abyssinia, as we read Habshi Abyssinia ka jo king tha, to uske mutalliq bhi Allah rakhe Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam ne gaibana janaza namaz padhaya tha. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked that why so good about Muawiyah ibn Muawiyah al-Muzani al-Laythi radiyallahu ta'ala an, kya you know unke bare mein kya hai, you know I know it's a sahabi, mujhe maloom hai ki ek sahabi hai, bahut sare mere sahabi passed away before also. To Jibreel alaihi salatu wasallam ne ajeeb jawab diya ke Muawiyah ibn Muawiyah al-Muzni aw al-Laythi wo sahabi the ke jo hamesha chalte firte. Walking, standing, driving, but at that time, sleeping or anything, even in his namaz, he will never leave a single second without reciting Suratul Ikhlas and Kul Huwallahu Ahad. Allah is saying ke Muawiyah ko mere saath muhabbat hai, mujhe Muawiyah se muhabbat hai, mere nabi ko kaho ke unke saath bhi muhabbat kare, lihaza janaza ki namaz ghaibana par aaye. This is the sharaf they were given. This was the mercy they were given. That because of the constantly reciting Suratul Ikhlas and Kul Huwallahu Ahad, Allah had love for Muawiyah ibn Muawiyah. Muawiyah ibn Muawiyah had love for Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also. So they was given a privilege unko ek sharaf hasil hua. It was an honor that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam been so far away, tab bhi salatul janaza Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam ne parhai. Ek ek riwayat milti hai. Dusri ek riwayat milti hai ke chand sahaba, they went to a safar or they went to gather together and they made one person imam. And this person, this other person, the other sahaba who was the imam, in all the rakats, he would recite Qul huwallahu ahad, Qul huwallahu ahad. All the rakats, all the namaz, he would recite Qul huwallahu ahad. So, ye sahabas, jo unke saath the, dusre, they came to the complaint to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam after the journey, ki, ya Rasulullah, aapne tum us aadmi ko imam banaya tha, ki jab namaz ka waqt ho jaye, to ye aapka imam hoga. Lekin, hamesha wo to Qul huwallahu ahad padhta raha, har namaz ke andar. وہ جان چھڑانے کے لیے نہیں ہم کہ ہماری طرح کہ جلدی ہماری نماز پڑ جائے ختم ہو جائے نو it wasn't like that کہ جلدی ہماری نماز ایک منٹ کی ہو جائے تو it wasn't just because they wanted to get rid of it all. This is a cricket match, you know, Pakistan is playing India, so quickly قل هو الله احد, you know, Man United play Man City, quickly قل هو الله احد. No, it wasn't like that. So Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam called this sahabi, he said یہ complaint لے کر آئے ہیں کہ بھئی سورۃ الاخلاص ہر رکعت ہر نماز کے اندر اللہ کے رسول مجھے محبت ہے سورۃ الاخلاص کے ساتھ. I have love with سورۃ الاخلاص and I read it because I have love with it and I have love for Allah. تو رسول اللہ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم نے فرمایا حبک ایاہ ادخلق الجنہ, تمہارا سورۃ الاخلاص کے ساتھ محبت ہونا یہی وجہ ہے کہ اللہ نے تم کو جنت دے دی. Your love for سورۃ الاخلاص is the reason that Allah has given you jannat. Allah has given you jannat. So obviously this is the sahaba radiyallahu ta'ala jama'in. Allah ka kalam hai. Even if it's one verse, one ayat, still is Allah ka kalam. Even if it's one small surah, is Allah ka kalam. Ikrima radiyallahu ta'ala an ke bare mein aata hai ke jab Quran padhte the to haar rakhte the, chumte the Quran ko, and he would say hada kalamu rabbi, hada kalamu rabbi, hada kalamu rabbi, ye mera rab ka kalam hai, ye mera rab ka kalam. So even one ayat, one surah is enough to have the love of Rasul of Allah in our heart. The Quran should be full of love. We should fully understand the Quran, the message of the Quran. But obviously, the love only will come in our heart or in our life. Jab hum usko constantly padte rahenge, we'll read and read and read. See, Ramzan khatam ho gaya, to Quran khatam nahi. Ramzan ke baad bhi Quran hai. Ramzan ke baad bhi Quran hai. Alhamdulillah, Ramzan ke andar we try to do more recitation of the Quran because it is a fazilat. But after Ramadan, there is Quran also. After Ramadan, it is Quran also. You know, this is a very famous saying, isn't it? Don't let the Ramadan finish and the Ramadan goes to the shelf. Because Ramadan is not for the shelf. Quran is not for the shelf. The Quran is for the self. Quran is for the self, not for the shelf. And it just gathered dust and dust. And when the next Ramadan comes, we open it again. Rozana, even after Ramadan, take 5 minutes out. Just read the Quran with love. Pyar se parho. With love. Even if it's three ayat, four ayat, three lines, four lines. But just read it. Inshallah, Allah's love will enter in our heart. So this is a very brief overview of Surah Al-Ikhlas. We'll translate it inshallah and then we'll conclude. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ. Very easy translation. قُلْ کہہ دیجئے, say اللہ احد, اللہ is one, اللہ ایک ہے, اکیلے ہیں. قُلْ say, قُلْ کا معنی ہے say, کہو اللہ احد, اللہ is one, اللہ اکیلے ہیں. اللہ الصمد, اللہ the eternal refuge. الصمد the eternal refuge, بے نیاز. مطلب یہ ہے کہ اللہ کسی کا محتاج نہیں, ہم سب اللہ کے محتاج ہیں. This is what it means. Allah Samad, Allah is not in need of anyone. We are all in need of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Regardless of our position, regardless of our titles, regardless who we are in the community, regardless how much money we have, regardless how much knowledge we have, how much ilm we have, how many titles we have, how many bungalows we have, how many cars we have, how much bank balance we have, still we are in need of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is Allah Samad. Allah is not in need of anyone. We are all in need of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَمْ يَلِدْ وَلَمْ يُولَدْ. Neither he was begotten, neither he was born. نہ اللہ نے کسی کو جنم دیا, نہ اللہ جنے گئے. لَمْ يَلِدْ, neither Allah given birth to anyone, neither he was given birth. نہ اللہ نے کسی کو جنم دیا نہ اللہ جنم دے گئے. So Allah has been from eternity. لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا احد ولم يكن له, and there is no one equivalent to him. ولم يكن له كفوا equivalent احد, no one, اور کوئی اللہ کے مثال نہیں ہو سکتا, برابر نہیں ہو سکتا. ولم يكن له كفوا احد, nobody can reach the status of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. With this we come to know also that not even a peer can get to the status of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not even a sheikh, not even a ustaz. چاہے جائے کتنی بخاری بھی زبانی یاد کر لے, کتنی بھی حدیث کی زبانی یاد کر لے, کتنی بھی قرآن مفسر بن جائے, محدث بن جائے, کتنی بھی مستجاب الدعوات بھی ہو, کتنے بھی حج کر لے, کتنے بھی کرامات ہو, کشف ہو, تب بھی اللہ کے مانن کوئی نہیں ہو سکتا. No one can become close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or be equivalent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is no one out there that can say to you, please make my guna maaf. No. Allah is the only one can forgive your sins. No one else. Nobody can perform namaz on your behalf. And nobody can say to you that, please, I've come with some problem. You know, you have the status. Mere guna maaf kar do. No. This confession in Islam, if you want to confess to someone, you confess to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You don't confess to anyone else. You don't confess to anyone else, you confess directly to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is the briefly introduction, overview and translation, tarjuma of this surah. I hope that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bring love of the Quran and in this surah in our heart also. And how the sahaba used to love the Quran, may Allah also make us amongst those that we love the Quran inshallah ta'ala. May Allah give us the correct understanding inshallah ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us a topic to practice upon what been said and heard also. And may Allah improve our Quran and enlighten our heart with the Quran. The tajweed rule will be the same as I explained yesterday, the qalqala rule, the qaf ta ba jim and dal. In this surah also there's a lot of qalqala. Qul huwallahu ahad, one qalqala. Allahus samad, lam yalid wa lam yulad wa lam yakul lahu kufuwan ahad. All the dals that we have in this surah at the end, when we stop and we do waqfa, all of them come under the rule of qalqala. So when you read the Quran, just try to read it with qalqala inshallah. It will be a mean of improving our Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hum sabko in baaton ke upar amal karne ki taufeeq naseeb farmaye. Wa sallallahu ta'ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Subhan rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun wa salamun alal mursalin walhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. Jazakumullahu khairan wa salamun alaykum wa rahmatullahi.